Now, this is a split call, 5 minutes each. I call the Honourable Nanaia Mahuta.
Tēnei e tuake ki te tuku ngā mihi ki a koutou. I tai mai nei ki te whakarongo ki ngā ahuatanga kei mui i te araro te whare e pāna ki ngā take tiriti nō reira ki a koutou katoa tēnā koutou. Madam Speaker, it gives me great privilege to be able to offer a few comments at the second reading on this particular bill. Because the Ngāti Kahununu ki here taunga tamatea claims settlement is something of a, I guess, a bit of a guide and some encouragement for other treaty settlements coming through the pipeline. So first and foremost, I wanted to acknowledge the Honourable Chris Finlayson. In his first reading speech, he set out quite succinctly, might I add, the historical context within which this particular claim was coming to the House, but he put in context what was being challenged in terms of the Crown not upholding its obligations. So, in summary, we can't ignore the fact that there was once a time where around about 1.4 million acres was the domain of the people who come here to this House now. And they lost around about 1.2 million acres of that land. In a period of time after quick succession between the 70s and 80s, as a result of native land law, a great proportion of their tribal rohe. But I was really moved when I went back to read the speech of Minister Finlayson, and he highlighted something I suspect he heard when he was going to gather his own evidence and information about the foundation for this particular claim. But there was a phrase that he quoted, that there's nothing more compelling than the statement from here taunga tamatea people when they said, being tangata whenua without whenua is something people can't comprehend. And I think it is hard to really make sense of that in contemporary terms unless you've lived and experienced the loss, the significant loss. I also draw on that statement because it's evident of a population of around about at the time of reaching settlement, I understand 15,900 people. A great majority of those people live outside of the rohe. So while we're talking about a settlement that I think a lot has been achieved, reconnecting and connecting people back to their place, their papakāinga, their marae, in such a deliberate way to build the sense of pride and identity of the here taunga tamatea people, I think is very, very important. The other thing I wanted to comment on briefly was the fact that Te Oti, some comment has been made today around Te Oti, and I heard the remarks of the previous speaker, and I too acknowledge that the issue of the Glasgow leases remain outstanding and they haven't been addressed. And while in part the settlement tries to, I guess, shine a light on the future opportunity of Te Oti being sustainable, it won't fully be sustainable until the issue of the Glasgow leases are resolved. At which point I should add that this is the subject of a delegation that has come to raise this very issue with me as the Minister of Māori Development, that I am keen also to see some approach to seeing if this can be resolved. It wasn't picked up during the amendment to the Māori Reserve Lands Act. This is a very difficult issue, which is why the previous government couldn't deal with it, and I'm not under any illusion that it will be easy for this government either, but we will embark on a journey to be able to see if there is a way. If there is a way, it will require agreement across the House if we're able to get to some kind of solution. The other thing I wanted to add is that there were very few challenges raised by the Select Committee in terms of the substance of the bill, which is why this is a brief contribution. So with that said, I want to acknowledge he tuataki tini, I want to acknowledge the negotiators, I want to acknowledge, actually, for those who understand just how difficult it was a special factors presentation that was made that I understand took this settlement and kind of pushed the settlement right to the outer limits of what could be achieved. So I commend them for their strategy, their foresight and their fortitude to ensure that a settlement resolves outstanding grievances that can rebuild the capability, the cultural pride of Ngāti Kahununu ki here taonga tamatia. Nō reira, tēnā tātou katoa.
Madam Speaker.
I call Chris Pink.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. It's a pleasure to rise.